again, and welcome to this week's Word for the Week. A time for us to pause in the midst of the busyness of the week and be still before God, to read His scripture, to pray, and to listen to some uplifting praise. Thank you for joining us today. Our Word for the Week this week comes from one of the best loved Psalms, Psalm 23, verse 4. Listen for the word of God. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You know, many times in our lives, we find ourselves in the middle of the valley. We're weak, tired, feel empty and alone. We can feel so far from the presence and the anointing of God. And even sometimes when we call on Him, we almost feel as if we're getting an engaged tone. I like to go hill walking. And there's a big difference between what it's like when you're at the top of the hill or the top of the mountain, and when you're surrounded by trees down in the valley. The trees block out much of the light, and things always seem brighter on the top of the mountain. But, you know, as much as we would like to, we can't live in the mountaintop all of the time. I think in part we experience these wonderful mountaintops to prepare us for our valleys. Down in the valley can be hard. Psalm 84 paints a picture of the valley of Baca. That word Baca means a place of weeping. It was a valley in Palestine, full of thorns and brush. But the thing is, God will care for us in the valley. Our word for the week tells us that He walks beside us. He comforts us. God will bring us out. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In 1 Kings, we are told about Israel being outnumbered by armies who believed that the God of Israel was God of the mountaintop, not the valley. And they sought to attack Israel in the valley, believing that for that reason they would defeat Israel. But God saw them through the valley. He proved that He is the God of the valley as well as the God of the mountaintop. I want you to know today that our God is our constant, our rock. He has promised that He will be with us always. He is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And He is the same God of the mountaintop when He's in the valley. And He will walk with us in our valley, provide for us, and comfort us if we call on Him. Amen. This October is a month of prayer for us as a congregation. And hopefully you have been following along with our prayer calendar for this month. Our prayer prompt for Wednesday, the 12th of October, is this: remember in prayer those in our community who are struggling, perhaps with addiction or financial issues or family issues. Pray that God would help us as a church to reach those in need. Let us have a few words of prayer. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you that you are the God of the valley as well as the God of the mountaintop. We thank you that you are our constant, our rock, our refuge in times of trouble. Help us to truly believe that you are there with us in all things, there to provide for us and to see us through our valley. Help us, Lord, to be a people of prayer who bring our cares and worries and lay them at the foot of your cross, where death was defeated and where eternal life for us was won. We thank you, Father, and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Our closing song this week reminds us that our God is with us in the valley, just the same as he's with us in the mountaintop. Our constant, our rock, our refuge. He will see us through. The song is called "The God of the Mountain is Still God in the Valley." Till next time, God bless.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God on the when things go wrong, he'll make them right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times, the God of the day is still God in the night. You talk when you're up on the mountain, but talk comes so easy when life's at its best. Now it's down in the valley of trials and temptations. That's where your faith is really put to the test. For the God on the mountain is still